شفت واحد جدول حامل فاينل نزل موجود على ال ام اس
ايوه يا دكتور.
تقريبا يوم 30 و2 مش كده؟
30 8
ايه؟
30 8
ايوه تلاقي يوم 30. طيب كده احنا هنعمل النهارده نشوف اخر شابتر كنا بدأنا فيه المره اللي فاتت شابتر 9 confidence interval and estimating sample size. قلنا if the parameter of population is unknown. كان في بعض الطلبه حضروا امتحان المتر ميك اب.
ايوه
مين انت؟
انا
كان في ثلاثة باين، في ثلاثة حضروا الميد تيرم ميك اب. كان سهل فيه. Chapter 9 your confidence interval. Now, if the parameter of population, a parameter of population, what is the parameters of population? Mean of population, it is parameter. Proportion of population, parameter. Standard deviation of population, parameter. If the parameters are unknown, then we can estimate them by selecting a sample from the population. We have two types of estimate. Point estimation. يعني أقدر بنقطة. If mu, the mean of population, if unknown, then we can estimate by the mean of sample x bar. It is a point estimation. If the proportion of the population by is unknown, we can estimate by the proportion of sample b. That is point estimation. We say before that there is a difference between value of population parameter and value of a statistic as an estimate of the unknown population parameter. If the mean of population mean, and we estimate it by the mean of the sample x bar, the difference between the sample mean and sample population, we call it error or sampling error. The sampling error is the difference between population value and sample value. To compute confidence interval, we need to determine factors. Point estimate, the statistic computed from sample information. That estimates a population parameter. X-bar statistic, estimate for mu population parameter. B, statistic, estimate for population proportion. if we need to estimate the mean amount spent by tourists visiting Canada. We can select a sample of 500 tourists and we ask them about their spending before their departure. Then we can compute the mean of spending. It is a statistic because it is a sample. And it is an estimate of population parameter as the mean of spending for tests. Confidence interval equal the value from the sample, which is a statistic, minus or plus the error sample. If we subtract the error sample from the value of statistic, that is the lower limit. If we add in sampling error to the value of statistic, that is upper limit. Then we can say the confidence interval for the mean or for the proportion between lower limit and upper limit. Then we can find the value of B from sample. How we can compute the error? To estimate the error, we have many factors determine the width of confidence interval. The number of observation in the sample, N. What is the sample size? The variability in the population, variance and standard deviation. The level of confidence interval. Levels of confidence interval can be 99%, 95%, 90%. مستوى الثقة لتقدير فترة الثقة ممكن يكون معامل الثقة 99% أو 95% أو 90%. يبقى we need what is the value of N, what is the standard deviation of population. If it is not known, we can use standard deviation of sample. What is the number of observations in the sample, which is sample size N? But we need N, we need level of confidence interval, we need the variance or standard deviation. If we know that, we can find the value of sampling error. Then we subtract from the statistic proportion or mean or adding to it to find the upper limit and lower limit. هنا الفاكتورز دي مهمة. Then we can find if the variance or standard deviation of population is known or the error unknown but the sample size is large. Sample size large means its size more than six. Then we can say confidence interval x bar for the mean plus or minus the value of z we can find from normal distribution times standard deviation of population over square root of sample size. Z times sigma over square root n, that is estimate of sampling error. Subtract from x bar to find lower limit, adding to x bar to find upper limit. How we can find Z? If a sigma, it is given in the equation, sample size given in the equation, X bar given, or we can compute from the equation. The mean of sample, if it is not known, we find the sum of all observation of the sample and dividing the sample size n to find X bar. Then Z, how we can compute it? Z is a standard value for normal distribution. Z standard normal distribution value. It is depend on confidence interval limit. If we need Z, divide confidence interval limit over 2 to find the area from 0 to 0. Search by using table of standard normal distribution about the half of confidence interval limit. As example, if the confidence interval 95 pips, we divided 95 over 2, then the result is 0.475. Search about this value for the area and inside the table, 0.475. Since we find it or the nearest value f, then we can find the value of Z is 1.9 under 6, then Z equal 1.96. If I take the corresponding value, this value has intersection of two values, 1.9 and 0.06, then the value is 1.96. That is the value of Z if the level of confidence interval 95%. By the same way, if the level of confidence interval 99, we divide it 0.99 over 2. The result is 0.495. Search about it, then we can find it is approximately corresponded to 2.5 under 8. Then the result is 2.58. Here between seven and eight, 2.5, between 7 and 8, 2.575. Or we can round it to 2.58. That is 495.47 correspond to 1.9 under 6, then Z equal 1.96. Then we substitute for this example, American Management Association, studying the income of store manager in the retail industry. A random sample of 49, the n equal 49, and the sample mean 45,400. The standard deviation of the population is 2,050. If a sigma known, then we use Z. Since the level of confidence interval 95, أنا مش متحدد بس لازم لا السؤال لازم يتحدد. But we divided 95% over 2 to 0.475. Search about this value from standard normal distribution table, then z equal 1.96. But then we have n equal 49 and x bar 45,400 and sigma standard deviation 2050. The question, what is the population mean? It is not known, it is unknown, but we can estimate it by the sample mean 45,402. Then the 95% level, x bar plus or minus z times sigma over square root. We substitute and our x bar 45,420 plus or minus z 1.96 sigma known 2050 square root 49 and 7. Then when we find the sample error, it is equal 574. Then the confidence interval is 45,420 plus or minus 574. 574 is the sample error. Then we subtract from 45,420, then the result is 44,846. And adding to 45,420 to find the upper limit of the confidence interval, 45,994. Then we can say the mean of income of manager between 44,846 and 45,994 with confidence interval level 95. Any question about that? If sigma unknown and the sample small, sigma unknown, then we use S, the standard deviation of sample size. And sample size small, then we use T, not Z. How we can find T? T depends on degree of freedom n minus 1. Achieve sample size, achieve n 1, that is degree of freedom. And how and limit of significant level, if significant level 95, then we need to find T corresponding to 75 confidence interval to side and degree of freedom. If n equal 25, the degree of freedom 24. If n equal 10, and so on. Then we use this formula. X bar plus or minus, we replace Z by T and we replace sigma by S. S is standard deviation from sample. As example, that is the table of T. Level of confidence interval, 80%, 90%, 95%, 99%, 98%, 99%. And that is the degree of freedom, the n minus 1. For this example, if this manufacturer of tire must not interrupt, يحاول يشوف عمره. Select the sample of 10 tires. اختار عينة من 10 tires. وجربوا لمسافة 50,000 ميل، وكانت النتائج بتاعت السامبل كالتالي: تآكل في القطار وزنين متوسطه 0.32 انش، في المتوسط كان تآكل القطار 0.32 انش، and the standard deviation from this thin tile than sample is 0.09. Because the sample size is small because it is less than 30 and the standard deviation unknown, then we use the distribution. Then at 95% and degree freedom n minus 1 equal 10 minus 1 equal 9, but then we need t 9 and level of confidence 95 from the table at 95 and in 9, the intersection between 95 and 9, 2.26. So we substitute, that is x bar 0.32 inch plus or minus t 2.262 times s 0.09 square root n square root a. By using your calculator, then the sampling error is 0.064. Adding and subtracting this sampling error from the sampling mean, then the result is lower limit 0.256 and upper limit 0.384. Then we can say that the confidence interval between 0.256 inch lower limit and upper limit 0.384 inch. That is with confidence interval level 95%. And the sampling error is 0.064. The value which we will subtract and add. Subtract from the mean to find lower limit, adding to the mean of sample to find upper limit. If the confidence interval for proportion, proportion from the sample equal number of units satisfy the attribute divided the sample size. And as example, if 20 students take exam in a study, 16 success, then probability of success 16 over 20. For proportion all sampling large, then we will use normal distribution for question about confidence interval of proportion. If B statistic represent sample proportion which equal x over small n. As example, we need the confidence interval for the population with confidence interval level 95%, maybe or 99. Then the formula is B statistic from the sample for proportion plus or minus Z times the standard deviation of sample proportion, which equal B times complement of B 1 minus B divided N under square root. If this value is the standard deviation of سام. Then number one, find B, find Z, substitute in the formula. That is example. What the flower of America is considering a proposal to merge with the Teamsters Union, an endemic Teamster. At least 3/4 of BBA members must approve, any merge. عايزين نشوف نسبة اللي هيوافقوا على الانضمام. A random sample of 2000 current members AB. 1600 plan to vote for the merger proposal. خدنا sample من 2000 1600 بيخططوا ويصوتوا مع الانضمام. What is the estimate of the population proportion? Population proportion for يبقى زين B that is the proportion from the sample. كم واحد موافق على الانضمام؟ 1600. التوتال السابق كان 2000. يبقى 1600 over 2000 equal 0.8. Now B equal 0.8. Since we need confidence interval 95 then Z equal 1.96. زي ما جبناها we substitute by B equal 0.8 plus or minus Z or 0.8 times 1 minus 0.8 over 2000 under square root multiply by 1.96. This result is the sampling error. 0.018. That is the sampling error. Subtract from B to find the lower limit, 0.08. Adding to 0.8 to find the upper limit. Then we can say the proportion of members reveals to vote for merger between 0.78% and 0.82% approximately. This proportion more than 75. Because the law determines that if the proportion of merger more than or equal 75%. لو الموافقة على الانضمام هتزيد عن 75% هي 3/4. Then we can say that the percent of merger 0.8 and confidence interval between 0.78 and 0.818. Since we need 75, then each of upper and lower more than 75 or greater than 75, then we can say the percent of accepting merger more than 75. If we need to determine the sample size. لو انا بعمل دراسة وعايز اخد سامبل ازاي اختار السامبل من كم؟ 100 200 60 16 9 what is the best sample size. We have sample size for mean or sample size for proportion. يعني your study about mean or your study about proportion. If you study about the mean, we have a rule for determining sample size. If you study about proportion, we need the table for proportion. Sample size. For determining the sample size for mean, we need the error margin. خط الخطأ كام؟ السنة وقلنا عليه sampling error في حدود كام؟ What is the level of confidence interval? 95% or 99%? Number two. What is the variation of population? Sigma. Then the formula for find sample size for your study. Value of Z, which you find it from the table for normal distribution standard, times variation standard deviation sigma, divided the upper, divided the margin error, and take the square of this division. Z times sigma over epsilon. All inside brackets to the power 2. Then to find the sample size of mean, we need the margin error, level of confidence interval, the variation in the population, and the formula to find the normal size, the sample size. طبعا لو طلعت فراكشن ممكن لها راوند تو نيرست يونت نيرست هول يونت. Example student in public administration want to estimate the mean monthly earnings of city council member in large city. She can tolerate a margin of error 100 أقصى sampling error in estimating the mean and the تقدير mean. She would also prefer to report the interval estimate with a 95% level of the student found a report by the Department of Labor that reported a standard deviation. Standard deviation known, 1000. What is the required sample size? Then the term of error 100 and level of confidence interval 95. Then divided by 2, shares with Z equal 1.96. And the standard deviation sigma 1/7. Substitute Z 1.96, sigma 1000, error 100. Then the result is 19.6, but a power 2. Does it افتكر ال power هنا 2. Here the answer, we give a power 2, we use sample size 19.6. Power 2 equals 384.16 يعني approximately 385 يعني ما فيش 0.16 اما يكون فيه سامبل سايز يعني عدد الاشخاص اللي هتاخدوا منهم البيانات، مفيش 0.16، يبقى ترى 0.16 هو شخص. دايما انا بعمل راوند لاكبر على طول، ما بقولش هي اكبر من 5 ولا لا. بس لي عندي 84 وبس لي عندي 85 بغض النظر عن الفراكشن. That is how we can compute the sample size. Any question or something? Any question?
تمام يا دكتور.
If the question about proportion, not about mean, we need the margin error, the level of confidence, the value of by there's a proportion of population to find the variation. Then we use sample size n equal z the same, error the same, all power 2, but we replace sigma square by pi times 1 minus 1. That is the standard deviation of sample proportion. E. Standard deviation of V pi times 1 minus 1. As example, if the student also wants to estimate the proportion of cities that have private refuse collectors. The students want to estimate the proportion with a margin error 0.10, because that is the error, and confidence interval 90, if 90 divided 2 to 0.45. If we search about it, then we can find z equal 1.645 على ايه between 4 and 5. يبقى ذات ايه؟ زد ذات از ذا ايرور 0.10 and no information about the proportion of population. The pi and no. Then let it equal 0.5. دايما لو كان الباي مفيش أي معلومات عنها حطها بنص 0.5. ليه؟ Because if we put pi equal half, then we have the largest sample size, أكبر sample size ممكن. أنا قلنا كل ما السامبل سايز تبقى أكبر كل ما الايرور يبقى أقل. يبقى then we substitute no information about pi, then pi equal half times 1 minus half. Half times 1 minus half, z 1.645. Error 0.10. Inside brackets, power 2. Then the sample size 67.65 equals 68. That is the rule for proportion. Pi times 1 minus 1. No information about pi, let it half. فيش أي معلومات عن the population proportion, هتحط the population proportion بـ half 0.5. Any question? في أي سؤال لو سمحت؟ With that sample size for proportion. That and sample size for mean. These factors to compute or to estimate the sample size.
دكتور.
نعم.
هو في الكونفيدنس انترفل امتى بستخدم الزي وامتى بستخدم التي؟
انت تستخدم ليه؟
في الكونفيدنس انترفل امتى بستخدم الزي الزي رول والتي رول؟
ده مش في السامبل سايز، ده في الكونفيدنس انترفل. قلنا في الكونفيدنس انترفل لو كان الفارينس فور سامبل and variance or standard deviation of population unknown. يعني ما عندكش value للسيجنال بس عندك value للستاندرد deviation from the sample يعني S. يعني F no sigma but you know S. And the size of sample small يعني 30 or less. يبقى لو السامبل سايز صغيره والستاندرد ديفيجن في البوبوليشن مش معروف لكن معروف في العينه يبقى نستخدم تي وليس زد. You understand؟
يا دكتور تمام.
في اي سؤال؟ نبدا من الاسبوع اللي جاي ان شاء الله هنعمل ريفيجن نجيب أسئلة على نموذج الفاينل ونحاول نشوف ازاي ندور. هنبدأ ريفيجن الأسبوع القادم من الكلام. أي كوتشن؟
دكتور لو سمحت الفاينل هيبقى إيه الانكلودد فيه الكود؟
في سؤال تاني؟
دكتور بقول لحضرتك الفاينل ايه اللي هيبقى داخل فيه في الشابترز كل الشابترز تبقى داخل فيه؟
ديسكريت ديستريبيوشن شابتر 7 نورمال ديستريبيوشن شابتر 8 اللي هو السامبلينج اند سامبلينج ديستريبيوشن بعدين شابتر 13 كونفيدنس انترفال اند سامبل سايز وشابتر 6 7 8 9 ده في الفايل.
فور شابترز يعني.
نعم
فور شابترز بس اللي داخلين في الفاينل يعني دكتور يعني ما ذاكرش 5 من قبل 6 ما ذاكرش ذاكر من اول 6
طبعا انت هتبدا من شابتر 6 هم 4 شابتر 6 7 8 9 حتى لو في اي اسئله او اي استفسارات او اي نقاط غير واضحه ممكن نعمل لها
دكتور
نعم
هي درجات الميك اب امتى هتطلع؟
هي لسه ما نزلهاش بعد ما نسجل
لا لسه
الميد تيرم ولا التوتال؟
لا انا عملت ميك اب بس لسه ما ظهرتش النتيجه تبعها.
لسه عملت ميك اب؟ احنا لسه ما صلحتهمش صلحهم ان شاء الله النهارده.
طيب تمام شكرا يا دكتور.
طيب ناخد الاتندنس. هشام صبري موجود؟
ايوه يا دكتور.
موجود. يوسف فراد.
دكتور هشام صبري تمام؟
يوسف فراد موجود؟ موجود.
ايوه يا دكتور مع حضرتك.
عمر احمد الزنافي مش موجود. نزار موجود
دكتور؟
نعم.
هشام صبري موجود بس المايك كان معلق. بس
اسمك ايه؟
هشام صبري اول اسم.
ايوه كتبتك حاضر. نزار محمد؟ نزار حاضر؟ لا. طه جمال؟
ايوه دكتور.
طه حاضر؟ اه حاضر.
ايوه دكتور.
انت كنت غايب المحاضره اللي فاتت طه؟
يوم الثلاث. اه يا دكتور معلش كان عندي ظروف بس احضر بقى في الريكورد.
كنت غايب
يا دكتور؟
الخميس اللي قبله برضه كنت غايب.
زي الخميس الخميس كنت موجود انت يا دكتور. والله بس انا كان عندي ظروف يعني الفتره اللي فاتت.
ابراهيم النجار؟ يوسف النجار موجود؟ لا. يوسف عبد الحليم امين؟ آية محمد ابو المد؟ آية حضرة؟ آية لا ابسط. الخواصي يحيى محمد و11. محمد حسام الدين أبشر. محمد غيث بكري فلا. محمد هشام زكي أبسط. عمرو محمد إسماعيل عمرو محمد اسماعيل موسى عمرو أبشر. احمد ايمن عبد المنعم احمد ايمن أبشر. سوزانا ميلاد أبشر. كريم خالد كريم حاضر ولا لا؟ لا. حازم ابراهيم محمد النجار
ايوه دكتور حازم ابراهيم
حاضر. مروان راشا مروان
ايوه دكتور مروان محفوظ حاضر
دكتور حاضر. عمر عماد محمد صديق سهل حاضر
ايوه دكتور.
نور الهدى حاضر
ايوه دكتور.
هيثم حاضر
ايوه دكتور موجود
حاضر. محمد عبد الرازق
مع حضرتك يا دكتور.
ايه
معاك يا دكتور.
محمد عبد الرازق انت كنت غايب المحاضرتين اللي فاتت.
اه المحاضره اللي فاتت اصلا عندي نفس الامتحان كنت براجع والله.
محمد حضرتك في الترم ولا
اه عملت ميك اب
ده
كان
مين
ده هو ده ولا شاه محمد الحسيني
محمد عادل عمر حسني عمر حسني ما حضرش ليه من التاني فنان البراء موجود. كيف الأسبوع اللي فات يا براء؟
أنا كنت غايب يوم الثلاث. غايب الثلاث بس.
محمد فؤاد. رمزي حاضر.
ايوه موجود.
موجود. حاتم حسن. حسن. يوسف أسامة موجود. ده كل اللي حاضرين. في حد اي سؤال او استفسار عشان هننهي المحاضرة؟ في اي اسئلة او استفسارات؟
ايوه يا دكتور.
نعم ليك سؤال.
حضرتك عندك اي ايميل او حاجة نقدر يعني نكلم حضرتك عليها مثلا في الاسبوع الجاي لو احتاجنا حاجة في المراجعة وكده؟
يعني توصلوا عاملين جروب يعني. ممكن تضموني الجروب.
هو طيب حضرتك ممكن تبعت رقمك طيب عشان نضيفك في الجروب؟
الجروب ممكن تضموني ليه؟ ممكن اكتب لكم التليفون.
ماشي.
أول شيء في اي سؤال بعت لكم على الشات الايميل والرقم على الواتس. اي سؤال؟
تمام يا دكتور.
شكرا اشوفكم الاسبوع القادم ان شاء الله يوم الثلاثاء. السلام عليكم.